Rapids first because I had a look at a car.
Red Hot Chippewas storm into the historic University of Notre Dame. It's the 9-1 Central Michigan Chippewas against the Notre Dame Fighting Irish. Hello everybody and welcome inside the broadcast booth. I'm Derek Steele alongside my broadcast partner Matt Ryder. Matt, before we get started, this past Wednesday, the year anniversary of the tragedy that happened at Oxford High School, four individuals lost their life. What a tragedy it was. And well, it was a year ago. We will never forget the names of Hannah St. Juliana, Madison Baldwin, Justin Schilling, and Tate Meir.
Yes, Derek, this is a very special moment for us to just remember those names, and those names will never be forgotten, just putting their lives, you know, at risk. It's a story that we need to always remember every year as we have the anniversary this year.
With that being said, the Chippewas, after their best start in program history, 9-1, looking to make it 10-1 tonight, what do they need to do to be able to extend that winning streak to three games?
Yeah, Derek, the Chippewas, they're coming off 17 goals in the last series against Loyola. 9 goals in the first one and 8 goals in the second one, so they're coming off a dominant game on both sides. And all they need to do is just trust themselves, make the right reads against this young Notre Dame squad tonight.
Speaking of the Notre Dame Fighting Irish, they're starting the season off at 1-3. They're coming off of being swept by the Adrian Bulldogs, who are currently in first place of the CCWHA. What do the Fighting Irish need to do? Not only extend their winning streak against the Chippewas this sixth game, but get back in the win column.
Yes, they beat Miami of Ohio earlier this season and a loss to Adrian in both games, so they need to get things going. They're a young squad, a lot of new players, and I think there's about 8 juniors. I was talking with the head coach, so, and they're moving around, and her philosophy is just have fun and be able just to play hockey at this level.
Central Michigan, as we said, they are 10-1 on the season. They're coming off of that 8-2 win against the Loyola Chicago Ramblers. A couple weeks ago from Loyola, they have outscored their opponents 51-19.
Oh.
Yes, you heard that right, Bulls. 51-19. The reason for that has been the goaltending. We're going to see Lauren Abraham in goal tonight, or as I like to say, Spider-Man. She's made some incredible saves this season. I like to compare her. I think I've used Superman this year. I've used Spider-Man. I'm going with Spider-Man tonight for Abraham.
Lockdown Lauren. That's what I call her. I believe she gets to start tonight, and it'll be really fun to get to see her out there and do her thing and just have a lockdown game.
That's not to discredit the other goalie, Bree Schroer. What a season Schroer's had too. Coach Haney talking to him this week, he said, look, I still believe we have the best goaltending duo in the ACHA. We saw Northern Michigan, they're struggling at goalie a little bit. Loyola Chicago just has one on Paige Nolan. She did a great job in that series against Loyola Chicago a couple weeks ago. Notre Dame, they seem to have a new goalie every game, it seems like. They got a new one in net tonight, so that's going to be something to watch out for if you're a fan of the Fighting Irish. How is this new goalie going to do in net for them? But man, it feels amazing being able to trust your goaltending no matter who it is, if it's Schroer or Abraham in net.
Yeah, just like you said, moving around with the goalies just to see what they can do. They've been giving up a lot of goals this year. Their notable game against Miami, they had a win and only gave up 4 goals. But with Adrian, it was 6-plus goals. So They need to be able to have a game plan here tonight and to slow down our Chippewas, which we are averaging just over four a game, goals a game. So
here's a fun fact for you, Matt. The last CMU win against Notre Dame Fighting Irish was February 18th, 2018. It was a 5-1 win right here from Compton Family Ice Arena. That's a 5-game winning streak the Fighting Irish have against the Chippewas. They'd love to extend that to 6, and I know if you're the Chippewas tonight, they want to end it at 5 games. Their mantra this year has been make history. What a season it's been for them. Sweeping Michigan State. They swept Bowling Green, split with Adrian, swept Loyola, swept Northern Michigan. They've been making history. They're second place in the central rankings right now for the ACHA Division II. What a season it's been for them so thus far.
Yeah, not only that, they've, you know, this season they have a lot of overtimes. I think about four overtime wins this year. All at Marty. Derek has not been in attendance during
the podcast. I've been there for one.
The first one, yeah. But shows that they're able to be resilient in tough games. And all of those overtime games, they were coming from behind. They didn't give up leads. They were coming from behind. So it just shows resilience and able to just stay with it during the hockey games. And, I mean, we lost to Notre Dame, I believe it was 8-0 and 4-0 for last season. So Chippewas are definitely motivated to come here and get their first win in 5 years, or 5 seasons, right?
Quick look around the CCWHA. The Wisconsin Eau Claire, did not know that was a college until this week doing prep for game.
Interesting.
They played Northern Michigan this afternoon at 3 p.m. We hope to get a score update from that game as soon as possible. Sioux and Michigan State, our game of the weekend to watch, the series of the weekend to watch. How are the Sioux Cougars gonna do in their first, I don't wanna say real competition of the season, but let's face it, they haven't really played anyone legitimate yet this year, so how are they going to do against the Spartans?
Yeah, I mean, to your point, Sioux College, they've scored over 100 goals this year and given up only 4. So, yeah, they haven't faced tough competition, but it just shows the consistency from Sioux College of what they're able to do game in and game out. So it'll be interesting to see what MSU can provide for Sioux College.
The final game around the CCWHA for tonight is Wisconsin against Loyola Chicago. That game is slated for 1 hour from now, 9 p.m. puck drop from Evanston, Illinois. Scratches for today, no one scratched for Notre Dame. Healthy injury report for them. Cannot say the same for the Chippewas. Something to watch out for tonight. They're coming to this weekend with 11 skaters. That's seven forwards, four defensemen. They're gonna run about two and a half lines tonight. Coach Haney staying in pregame. There's going to be a lot of ice time for the players here tonight. We wish the Chippewas who did not make the trip to Indiana their best wishes. Who are your players to watch out for tonight, though, Matt?
For the Chippewas, we have Caitlin Williams and Del Rey, I believe. And Del Rey, I believe, has 17 goals in the year. Is that right there?
17? That sounds right. 16
on the year. Caitlin Williams with 7 goals and 10 assists. For her to be able to be that point guard on the team, beating her teammates, it's amazing. And most of the two players are going to have the odds for CMU.
For Notre Dame, it's going to be Megan Nickman, the goaltender. We said it earlier. Defense wins championship. Good goaltending wins championship. We've already talked about it tonight. New goaltender for the Fighting Irish. How she can be with you in her first start. The other one is Chloe Ringer. She's second on the team in points. Had to lead 8 goals. She's averaging 2 points a game. That's including 1 power play goal and 1 game winning goal on the season. 2 Fighting Irish to watch out for there. What are your keys to the game, though?
Keys to the game. Winning your face offs. At least 50% of them. Be able to stay humble, you know, coming off 17 goals in the last series of Loyola Chicago, you know, have the same mindset, you know, whether if you're up by 8 goals or you're down by 8 goals, have that same mindset that AD is trying to implement to the team. And the last one would be win your one-on-one battles. It's a talented CMU squad offensively and defensively. So on the defensive end, having Wojtas, Matt Cornett, Steele Lee, lockdown on defense and on offense is when you're one-on-one battles and you're challenging for that. So
man, this is something I thought I'd never say this season.
not tell who that was that picked it up in the zone. But it's going to be Haney at mid-ice. Sounded like a whistle none, though. As that's going to wrap around McVinn. That's an Irish player to grab it. Cannot tell who that was. Palmer with it, though, in her own zone. Big shout out to Palmer's dad, Todd, for running camera for us tonight.
Oh my goodness, what a lifesaver.
We were able to get him early enough today to run camera for us. That's Whitus. A bad Barnett pickpocketed, but there's a teammate there, Whitus, who is able to grab it. Whitus from midpoint. Whitus lost in front, and McFinn comes up with the save.
Whitus just trying to be more aggressive. I had a conversation with her. She's just trying to be more aggressive. She wants 5 goals on the year. That's her, one of her goals. Play on words there. One of her goals for the season. As she gets
as that's
going
to be tried to clear. I cannot tell who that was that saved it in. I think that was Delray. That's nice. Actually, with Delray able to get her nameplate on the back of her jersey, finally, for the second half of the season, she's no longer the silent assassin as icing's waved off there. Mixon will grab it along the boards in front of the Chippewas bench. That's Williams who tried to grab it, wasn't able to. Williams doesn't give up on the play, though. Irish keep it on sides, and that's going to go wide at Abraham. There's Castillo with it. Castillo wraps around the boards. Leotito has it pickpocketed from her. Seedman, shot on that, blocked by Castillo. Kept in the zone, though. Haney tried to get it. It was Delray who comes and grabs it. Sorry, that's Hubert who grabbed it. 66 Brooke Hubert. Woo! As that was an Irish player falling down, going after the puck. I could not tell who that was. As that's onside. Wraps around behind. Whitish will grab it in the corner. Whitish just dumps it down, and icing's going to be the call.
Well, two players, like we said in the pregame, to look out for on this Notre Dame squad is Addie Steinke and Chloe Bangringer. But they both have 6 goals on the year leading the team. And those are the players that we're going to have to keep a lookout as we...
As that's Whitus to pick it up. Whitus hassled, is able to get it to a teammate that's over to Nixon. Nixon, trying to get it ahead, tries to find Leotino, isn't able to. Somehow that puck gets down the sideboard, wasn't able to see him pick it up, but Palmer has it at midnight. Palmer, all alone, Palmer shot wide. Palmer in the corner. Gets it, has her pass intercepted. Trying to find Nixon as that's Haney kicking it on sides. That one will wrap around the goalie. There's Castillo to pick it up. Castillo, a late addition to this game today. Glad she can make the trip out to Notre Dame though. As that one is in. That might be one of the weirdest goals I've seen. I cannot tell you who scored that one, Matt.
Well, we'll see in a second here. Yeah, everyone just like shouted out in the air.
No goal. The call on the ice is no goal. That one's going to be waved off. It's going to be to the goalie's right. That's McVinn.
Both squads just trying to get a good area up.
That's going to be wrapped around. That was Hubert who tried to get it. Watch out. Chippewas hit numbers. There's Delray. Delray shot on that. Save. Rebound. As that's going to be kicked away.
Time that was a great opportunity for Del Rey there. Almost had it. Goalie making a great effort to keep that puck out of the promise.
That's what you do in the PAs. Come on, Homer and Del Rey. Watch out, Chippewas. Watch out. Del Rey hasn't poked away. What? That was McKenna who poked it away.
What a pass by Palmer to kick it out to the offensive zone to Del Rey, but also a great effort defensively for this Notre Dame squad to move it away. That way, that's a great shot.
Castillo will grab it in the corner. Jones on the forecheck. Trust me to catch the defender. That's where a Notre Dame player will pick it up. Hubert, sorry, that's Nixon. Nixon shot on that, just wide. Garnett's going to try and rebound. 13:02 left in period number one. Glad you could be here with us from Compton Family Ice Arena. Derek Steele alongside Matt Ryder. Matt Potter, our cameraman tonight. Here's a two-game series. Make sure to stay tuned. Tomorrow, 12:30 p.m. will be the puck drop time. Is that's going to be stolen in there right now. And that was cleared by Nixon. Is that's going to go to land to the ice. I expect ice to be all as it is.
Yeah, almost 8 minutes into this first period, and it's been pretty even on both sides. But the Chippewas are starting to give edge here with great passing by Leah Palmer. She leads the team in assists. And Del Rey with the opportunity down in the offensive end, but stopped by the Notre Dame Irish.
Face-off won by the Chippewas. That was one of your keys to the game today, Matt. Being able to win those face-offs, they did a good job there. As that's stolen by Nixon, trying to get out of the zone, he's able to first and second. And there's a wrap around the ground. Circle, stop and go. But that's Burnett to help him out. Burnett tries to get it to Palmer. Palmer had it stolen from her skate, or from her stick, sorry. Shot on that, saved by Abraham. And she's going to pounce on that for the whistle.
Lock down Lauren. Making sure that she puts an imprint on this game, making her name known.
What I really like from Abraham there is she used her stick to stop it, and then she trapped it with her glove to be able to take it with her glove. That's something we've talked about for a lot. It's allowing too many rebounds to share. Good play by her to make sure that A, it doesn't go to the high goal, and B, there's no rebound there. Castillo. Shot just wide of Nixon. Chippewas will try to wrap it on the board. That's where the Irish will pick it up. That's on the ice. As a clear trip and once again saved by Abraham. I did not see if that was at the shot. That was McKenna with the shot.
Slip and slide action by McKenna.
11:22 from 11:22 left in
here. The ref just waved at us.
What?
The ref just waved at us.
Oh, I did not see that.
I don't know if I know him personally. I love it. It's a great view here.
Shot on that. Oh, just wide. Nice block there by Abraham.
Yeah, very great view here. We're lucky to be a part of it. Broadcast right.
You feel like you're on top of the action. It's just hard to call it from the other end.
Oh shit.
Del Rey's trying to grab it on the forecheck. She's not able to. Another Chippewa player grabs it though. Will retreat to center ice for Palmer. Just as she can grab it. She will be able to. Off the board, trying to get it to William Jose and who steals the puck though. Palmer, watch her go first to go. She stops though. Gets it up to Williams to Castillo. Castillo shot of that. She scores! One of the Notre Dame Chippewas lead 10-23 up in period number one.
I believe that was Del Rey.
Was that Del Rey on the shot? It was Del Rey on the goal.
Del Rey with an opportunity. And when you said Castillo, I got excited. I was like, oh, first goal of the year.
Hey, it looked like 17 for me.
It's okay, but that is number seven. Speaking of 17, that's number 17 for Kylie Del Rey. Making an imprint in this game, 10-23 to go. And, you know, don't be surprised if you see a great game from her today, as she's been doing great all year with 3 Hatties and 10 games against this young Notre Dame squad. You can definitely, she'll definitely have a lot of opportunities to put the puck
and that,
in the promise.
We were playing Notre Dame, Matt. Or did you say Notre Dame or Purdue?
I
think you said Purdue. Maybe I'm just hearing things.
Let us know in the comments, guys, if I said Purdue 10 seconds ago.
Our score is upside down now. Hold up, let me fix that really quickly. We're having some technical difficulties. Apologize for that, folks. You can blame Matt Ryder's computer for these technical difficulties today.
Steely doing a great job.
Oh, now we can't see it. Great. Why can't we not see the score bug?
I feel like Steely being very aggressive here early in this first period. Just being on top of the puck and being aggressive. We have the captain back for a game. Ryan Wilson. Oh, great toss. Katie out there for the CMU Chippewas. Notre Dame also doing a pretty good job passing the puck. It's just been even on both sides. Chippewas has the upper hand, I believe. Lockdown stop those pucks. Here's a breakaway for the Chippewas.
There we go. Score should be fixed there. Sorry for the technical difficulties, and that's Palmer grabbing it out of the blue line shot to slide. We're seeing a lot more confidence forming around those shots though.
Oh yeah. She's shooting like she.
There's a player hits the deck. No penalty call. That was 13 yen hit the deck. I really thought they were going to get Palmer on the cross track there.
I thought so too.
Katie, like 2 inches in front of me. There's Abraham, deflects it to Palmer. Palmer tried to fight Wilson. And that's going to be kicked out to Barnett and dumps it in the zone. Chippewas will not go off for a line change. As it's Whitish and Leotino who come out of the ice. Watch out. As it's given back to Leotino. By Leotino, he tries to grab it at mid-ice, isn't able to. There's a dog pile right at mid-ice, as there's not anyone with it so far. It comes out, as that's Williams. It comes out with it. Williams, watch out, Williams. She's deadly with the book. Williams shot on that save.
Stuff very handles out there.
That will kick out to Whitish. Whitish over to Williams. Williams over to Delray. Tried to find Whitish, wasn't able to. As the Chippewas will retreat for the puck, that's the Sterling comes back right in front of me to grab the puck. When I say these players are like 2 inches from me, they're like across the glass from me.
Courtside seats.
Courtside seats. It doesn't, can't get used to this view. Leotino pokes it away, tries to dump it in the zone. That's where the Irish will go back for it. As it's going, watch out, Huber tried to get a handle on it and isn't able to, as she hits for that.
Wow, Huber doing her best impersonation of Williams using her handles.
And then the driver is like, I'm going to hit this one, just go back to the face. Almost over. So it's Delray. Delray's going to be the one to come out of the title with her. As that is on our side, cleaning with it. Love to see goal number one tonight from 80.
That would be great.
What do you think Christian's reaction would be?
Well, you said last time, Derek, that he would give her a big hug or something like that. I don't think that would happen.
Hubert.
But maybe.
Shot on that save by McKinnon. Rebounded from. Because that's going to be corralled by an Irish player.
Maybe Coach will require Taylor Swift tickets or
something. Is that gets it up and trying to find out what he's able to do. He's still neat. Just dumps it. Was able to get it back in there over. White is trying to grab it. And just going to still need to come out with it.
Was still making a name for herself. Just touching the puck. You know, every other possession here. Giving herself an opportunity for her teammates.
As the Phillies won by the Irish, that speech may be one of the ways. Captain, no. Chippewas need to clear. The Skilly will try to do that. Captain, though. Chippewas are able to get a line change. Both teams are able to get a line change because it's whitish with it. Whitish to the left. Shots it out the corner. We still have to retreat for it.
She corrected us.
Garnett will drive it.
She corrected us on the bus. Because we used to call her Roy Toss, or at least I did. It was white.
Garnett.
Sorry, Dad.
Maybe half. Over the corner. Palmer will start pulling back. Get it out to Wilson. That's number two in the line. Is there going to be a whistle? Someone?
Fans, don't forget to CMU Club Hockey Network YouTube channel. It's your one-stop shop for highlights, exclusive interviews, and full game podcasts for the CMU Women's D2 and Men's D3 Hockey. Make sure to subscribe and turn on notifications so as to never miss a moment of football hockey. Go to the YouTube channel, CMU Club Hockey Network, and find us.
William shot on that just wide, might have ricocheted off of McFitt. As the last stop of the play was an offside to the average. As Palmer's going to be picked up on the corner, trying to catch it. She's able to get it, knock it away. That's the woman to pick it up. Up to Leotino. Leotino showing off the speed. Leotino over to William. Quarter. Williams up ahead to Whitish. Whitish shot on that. Deflected off. I believe that might have deflected off an Irish player. Tried to find that's Leotino and the crease wasn't able to. As Palmer will grab it, sorry, that's Delray. It is hard to see the difference from down here when you're on that head. There's Delray in front of the net. Oh, how did Williams not stop that? Oh, Leotino, and she scores! 2-0 lead for the Chippewas here in period number two.
I think that was Leotino.
Grace Leotino.
That's her second on the year. Wow, but yeah, that puck was going back and forth in the offensive zone for the Chippewas. And like Derek said, it's very hard to see on our end from where we're standing. It took us a second to see who it was after everyone was hugging Grace Leotino. And that took a second of the year. Congrats, Grace. 2.5. Yes, let's go! There's another goal by Delray, I believe. No, it is hard to see. Nixon, that is Gabriella Nixon. I believe that is her 7th goal of the year. And that's 6 goals in 6 games. The last 6 games for Gabriella Nixon. As she's continuing her hot streak, putting the puck in the net. I asked her what's contributing to her hot streak, and she just says, you know what, I'm just getting my opportunities, and I'm just putting the puck in the net.
I wasn't even able to pull that one. was running Tom Valentino goal, and all I hear is that goal, goal!
I got you.
That shows you that, but that shows you the forecheck and the power by the Chippewas. We've talked about it all year. As that's Flood fighting Palmer in the corner, Palmer's gonna look like win that battle. She is. 1:56 left in the period. Castoni will grab it. Tries to get up ahead to Hubert. She's able to. Hubert to Nixon. Nixon, watch out. Chippewas have numbers. Nixon, can she get the second out of the night? Is that saved? Or no, it's not saved.
Shot left wide.
Castoni up ahead, Delray. Ooh, I'm out of breath.
Almost done here. Full game. 1:26 left here. So hold on tight.
There will not be an intermission report. First intermission report. There will be a second one. And one going to be ice here at Notre Dame. So we will take a quick break after this period, but no intermission report. There's Delray. Delray tries to split two defenders. She was able to find a teammate. Wilson wasn't able to, though. Shot on net. Ricochet in front, and Nixon with this save.
If you're looking for game reports, stats, schedules, and more, take a trip to CMUWomensHockey.com. There you can find those and much more, including player information, recruiting information, apparel, and much more. That's CMUWomensHockey.com.
As the Irish, I believe, was able to win that faceoff, trying to get something on the forecheck, Katie saying no thank you. And Matt, Michigan just scored.
Wow.
41 seconds left in the period. Wilson, pick pocket it. Watch out, as that one's just going to go to the corner. As she acted it off the line change, that is dead. Barnett tried to fight for it, as that's going to be Delray who grabs it. Delray, 24 seconds left, 22 seconds. Delray circles in that. Gets it over to Williams. Out to Palmer. Palmer shot on that just wide. But there's traffic in front. Puck goes to the corner. Palmer. And that's going to be the end of period number one. Chippewas on the shore. Pier after one. 3-0. We'll be back right after the break here on CCHN. As we're back, ready to start period number two. Chippewas on the attack, let's mix it with it. William trying to fight for it behind the net. Trying to grab it, is able to. Push into the boards. There's Leotino. Leotino trying to find a teammate in front, it's blocked. As that's going to be a player that's Yem, who tries to clear, isn't able to. Irish half possession. Steeman will clear up to Yem. Loses it for just a split second. Just dumps it in. And it's going along the boards. Into the zone by Castilny. Yeah. Gives way to a teammate. Still somehow comes up with it. Because that's going to go the length of the ice. Palmer in the corner. Delray will grab it. Delray up ahead. Saudi pushed off the puck. And that's where an Irish player will grab it. That was Gold who grabbed it. Palmer circles behind Abraham. Giuseppe Feeney has her pass intercepted. Delray's able to come help her for a second. Hubert will collect. Tries to clear, isn't able to. Attempt number two, still kept in. As it's circled down the net, Abraham's trying to locate it as she bounces on it.
Kind of a recap of the first period. As we said, Del Rey, that's her 17th on the season. And then we have Nixon. That's 7 on the year for her. Tied with people in goals. Nixon, Zotti, and Del Rey able to score most of the goals that Chippewas this year on that line.
The Del Rey goal was assisted by Williams. Gets bad a point in like the land.
Woo!
I know she would love to go up and get a break. Up and look at that. This being the last series before the halfway point to the Chippewas. Last series for the first half, because that's going to be shot, blocked. And front just kicked away. Goes trying to get it to flood as there's a whistle. I believe the puck went out of play, so that's going to come right outside the Chippewas zone.
50 goals, 50, just over 50 goals for the season for the Chippewas squad, giving up 19 on the defensive end. So it's top of the standings, but along with Adrian and Sioux College. They have just a, well, she has 100 goals on the year, and they've got 84 goals on the defensive end. And Adrian has super stats with us.
Irish with the puck, stolen by, I cannot tell who that was, I believe that was Palmer, yes it is, Palmer, showing up the speed, just fine, that William for 25 to quarter, oh yeah, over the Delray, who was an able to get that over. It's the period. It's going to be Irish returning to go. As it's stolen, but controlled by the Irish. Finally, the Chippewas are able to get it as a pile of bodies hit the ground. Up ahead, Williams kicks it. Can somehow find it still in the first split second. Williams with the puck again. Delray, puts the middle. Williams, back to Delray. Oh, I tried to manifest it. Tried to manifest that goal there. It didn't work. This Williams with it. The front Saudi shot of that. She scores! Zoe Saudi making it a 4-0 game.
Saudi able to knock that in using her pink hockey. Her pink stick. And that would be number 6 on the year for Zoe Saudi, I believe. I have to double check on that. She's
number 7 on the year for Saudi.
Number 7. So these Chippewas,
as that's not good, the Irish goaltender is down. I believe her lace just needs, her skate needs to be retied.
Yeah, that looked a little weird. I don't know if she was injured.
Luckily, she's good to go.
Teammates are helping her out. I mean, it's hard to tie your shoes with all that bulky.
Ask Joel about that. He would know.
Oh, yeah. They look like big gorillas. Like it's hard to tie your shoes with all that equipment on your back. But that just shows the culture for Notre Dame, just helping out a teammate
in need.
And at mid-ice, you see three Notre Dame players just talking about what they want to do coming out of this whistle, out of this break. And just talking with the coach, you know, she's a volunteer and she's just trying to implement a culture where it's fun playing for the North Carolinas. The squad looks like they're having fun and giving them all out efforts against our mighty cheerleaders.
Irish with the puck, trying to find something, finally gets it out. Saudi will try to knock it out of the zone, isn't able to, because that's going to hit a Chippewas player in the flat, Wyatt Abraham. As that was Nixon trying to play for it, isn't able to. Abraham doesn't see it for a second and finally is able to pounce on it.
You know what player that has been sticking out to me in this game there?
Who?
Leah Palmer. She's
Leah
Arnold Palmer. She's been able to be very aggressive and just like be all over the ice. And she just has an extra pep in her step.
Good ricochet there by Abraham. To her right.
So don't be surprised if you see a goal from her
today. White is? Tried to get it to Barnett, how many times intercepted though? That was intercepted by Duel. As there's a fight for the puck, finally, Chippewas players are fighting, but that was Blaydes. That's another name I've said a lot tonight, Nicola Blaydes. She's had herself a really quiet but good game so far, too.
Yeah, the Chippewas are definitely taking the upper hand here early in this game.
14:43 left in period number 2. Derek Steele alongside Matt Ryder. Is this going to be a stoppage in play?
Ouch. That puck just hit an Irish D.
As it's going to face up at center ice or right outside the Chippewa zone. I cannot tell. It's going to be outside the Chippewa zone.
The Irish left to slip inside. As you can see, a couple falls here in the second period.
Solid music choice here from Notre Dame so far. What did you say about?
It's mid. I don't really like it.
Well, you're not into that type of music.
Yeah, so. Country.
You know, Reagan would enjoy it. Reagan would actually be dancing with me.
No one cares about
it. As Barnett's going to try to choose their own clothes, she looks at the race. She's trying to get it to a teammate, Delroy. Gets it out. To Haney, Haney had her shot mark. No, I didn't put him in that trigger to burn that. Wilson had a shot. Ooh, I wanted Wilson to score that there. There's Steichman.
Ooh.
Steichman trying to go coast to coast. Steichman showing up the stick moves off of Abraham. Let's say there by the Chippewas net liner. Because here's Palmer. Palmer were just trying out with Barnett, actually. Just dumped over the last page. Delray went after it. Got hit off the puck though. Williams tried to go after it. And finally, it's Blaydes who's able to grab it. Vietino tried to find Williams, just a little strong at that pass. As that's Nixon who goes back to grab it. Back to Vietino, who's going to have to retreat for it. Actually, that's extremely 17. There's Cool. I lost the puck. There it is. This Castilli. Castilli cross ice. Shot on that. Just wide. Williams.
as that's going to be kicked out. Charge the Chippewas player going for it. That was deep. Excuse me.
Leotino has a flamethrower of a shot. That came out just fiery.
I remember watching the first practice that we went to this year, and we saw the team doing the down and back drill that they do every practice, and there was just one player that just seemed a little bit faster than everyone. It was Grace Leotino.
Wow, okay.
She has that speed.
Okay, Grace. Don't count out Caitlin Williams. I still think she's the fastest player on the squad.
Williams has some speed too. There's Palmer.
You can tell Palmer's just, she's in the game. She's in the zone.
Palmer's, it's a new confidence actually for Palmer. Last game, ever since she got in her first goal against Royal, it's a new confidence.
I think whoever's parents does the camera, they just do really well in this game. Like Del Rey's dad.
Thank you. Thank you, Todd.
Del Rey's dad is helping.
By the way, Todd did bring us water today. Just wanted to put that out there.
Last series, and Del Rey had a great series. Now,
this is still fluctuating to the Sorry. Falls down. Sorry, still trying to play for it. They're resilient. He's really sorry.
Defensive forecheck for the Irish, just standing up, being tough, and not letting that goal.
Number 21, left in period number 2. Make sure to stay tuned for the next dead puck. We will have this day in Chippewas history. Got a good one today.
Slip inside.
And there's going to be the save from Abraham. I'm going to scooch over and grab the screen from Matt. You ready for this day in Chippewas history?
Always, let's do it.
That's a good Bon Jovi going. This day in Chippewas history. We're going to go back to the winter of 1905. Earlier this year, I believe it was in the Northern Series. We talked about it being the 50th year of Title IX, equivalency for men and women in and outside of sports. We're going to go back even farther, back over 100 years ago, 1905. CMU women's basketball played their first game versus Midland High School. Back then, they were known as the Lady Normalites. They won their first game 24-13.
Wow.
How about that? How about that score, Matt? 24-13. Don't see that a lot in collegiate basketball nowadays.
Mic drop. Great day in history for the Chippewas.
As that was this day in Chippewas history. Can't wait to see what Matt comes up with for tomorrow.
It's gonna be a good one, I think.
As Abraham will hold on to that puck for the stoppage play. Quick check at the out-of-town scoreboard. Michigan still up 7-0 in the Big Ten Championship for who's driving, right? At the Michigan goal line, 4:13 left in the first quarter. Almost said first period there. My brain's still on hockey. As it's going to be a face-off in the Chippewa zone. It looks to be to the left of Abraham. As there's the play on signal from the referee. That's into the corner. As that's going to be icing on the Chippewas. That's going to go back into the Irish zone. See what side, or let's see what side they want the face off on. It looks like they're going to go to the right side. Did you know the team that not the team that iced the puck, the opposing team gets to choose what side they want the face off on?
Really?
So let's say we have a really good left-handed shooter that shoots from the left point really well. You're going to put it on the left face off circle. Same if you have a right or a shooter that's really good from the right point, you're going to play on the right face off circle. So let's put that there for you, man. That's really interesting. And the team that ice the puck cannot change lines. So they got to keep their same line on the ice.
Okay.
Purdue scored a touchdown.
Oh, Purdue.
7-7.
Don't worry. Michigan fans, we got this in the bag. Take the dunk.
Don't say that.
Yeah.
As that.
Broadcaster's genius. Yeah.
There's Williams. Sorry, Palmer. I don't know how to say it. There's Palmer. Palmer's straight up the speed. Every single ball on the side, just like goes in third.
Dude, look at that sequence. Palmer with a great shot, and she went and grabbed the rebound, try to put it back in the goal.
9:08 left here in the third. Chippewas out to a 1-0 lead from Compton Family Ice Arena, first of a 2-game series. Make sure to stay tuned for game 2 of the final matchup scheduled for 12:30 p.m. Right from the Bay Arena. Let's move on to Patrick Kennedy.
Lots of energy from the CMU squad. You can see it even behind this big wall that's keeping us away from the players.
Williams deflected it, still somehow got to an Irish player. That one's going to go into the corner. That's where Flood will grab it. Out to Steve Smith shot at that. Oh, just wide. I thought that might have been in the back of that for a split second.
Chippewa is doing a great job keeping the puck on their offensive zone.
Williams hits the deck. There, Chippewa player,
Max Huber, pushing
the corner.
My apologies, defensive.
Numbers for 7. He's going to set up the offensive screen. Shot back.
There
you
go.
You know what's been really nice about this game so far?
What's that?
There hasn't been any penalties. It's been a really clean game from both teams.
Yeah, both teams, both squads having a lot of energy. And to your point, just
there hasn't really been that many stoppage. I mean, it's a save by a goalie here, save there, offsides here and there, a couple of icings. But there hasn't been that many stoppages in play.
Yeah, playing a very clean game. Sides.
Probably the cleanest game we've seen from the Chippewas so far this year.
Yeah, something about this game is we're just on top of it. And 4 goals to show with 7 minutes left in the second period.
For Saudi, watch out. Saudi might have a breakaway shot on that. Oh, what a save! Fifth and going high as she's falling down to make the glove save.
Wow, so we saw it coming down by the right circle and shoots it up high, and the goalie for Notre Dame able to Alright. I guess their song chose it for me.
Don't try to do that. The CMU is the best listening. There's Saudi. Somehow is able to keep it outside, but that one's going to get you with the eyes. As that's going to be. Wait, icing's waved off, but didn't go in the way for the ice as I thought it was going to. Oh, here we go. Delray, up ahead. There's Nixon. Nixon backs off. There's a loose puck in front. Corral, Nixon trying to go after it, just Saudi. Blood was able to clear it though. Just wide to Delray. That pass was from, I believe, Palmer.
Chippewas definitely have an extra pep in their step as Nixon was being a silent assassin trying to pick.
Something that I said to watch out for was that short bench for the Chippewas, a lot of ice time. Now, granted, we're still. Got a period and 6 minutes left to go, but it doesn't seem to be affecting them. They seem to still have that same amount of energy as they did in minute one.
Yeah, Notre Dame doing a really good job breaking down their defensive forecheck.
There's Delray. 2-on-1 in favor of the Irish. Delray trying to get towards the goal. Oh, nice save there. By McVay.
That was so smooth by
Delray. Delray tries to go to the backhand. We've said it all year. Sprouse going off the backhand. Trying to go to the there once again.
Being cool, calm, and collective, taking her time. Making sure she gets the right shot opportunity there. But as I was saying, this Notre Dame squad doing a very good job in the defensive forecheck. Limiting to this Chippewas to low goals here in the second period after 4 goals in the first. I apologize.
And that's going to be collected in the corner by Monette.
I think that stat line is just a little bit off. We'll get the right one.
Shot in front, deflected as that one's going to go behind Abraham. Who still need to try to clear it. She went. Up in front, shot on that, as that's right at Abraham. She's got that same ball, man.
How many goals do we have for the second period? Just one. One goal. Yeah, okay, so three goals in the first period. So, Notre Dame doing a very good job. I mean, shot by the Chippewas. We got opportunities from Zoe Sani. He dealt with a goalie for the Irish able to knock them down.
I'm glad there's not a camera on us all the time, see my four of the things. I apologize to Matt.
Thank God.
He has to handle my superstitions. My bad fans were team up with the shot. Just
like Leah Tia just passed that puck between her legs. No look pass.
Leah Tino tried to dance that one into the back of that. See what I did there? We're talking about
dancing.
Not all my jokes are gonna be good, Matt. You should know that by now.
You have a chance to redeem yourself.
3:46 left in the period. There's a Chippewas player trying to grab it. Not telling them that. Watch out, Chippewas have numbers. Watch out. Hubert shot on that. Oh, nice save there by McFinn.
Wow.
William's still trying to go after her own puck. She's fighting for it. Finally comes out with it. Williams, over to the score. He's trying to steal Tino. Just not. Tino trying to net her second one of the night.
Beautiful touch pass by Caitlin Williams. Tino unable to handle it.
William the front. Leotino wasn't able to reel that pass. As that one's going to go to the corner, Lennis is going to chase it down. Both teams very line changing. Watch out for Saudi. Saudi with it right now. Saudi showing up the moves. Saudi, once, twice. As that goes into the corner. Saudi in front of the net. No one was home for the Chippewas. We've seen that time and time again. That pass from the corner, from behind the net, in front of the net. It's worked time and time again for the Chippewas. It's here to save by Abraham. No one was home though in the crease. I think it might have worked again. I think they had their fair beat there. If only someone was in the crease.
Chippewas turning up their intensity, having another breakaway opportunity by Nick Huber. The goalie for Notre Dame just able to make those big stops. Kudos to you. Who is
McVin?
Nixon?
McVin.
McVin, as good Derek, job. As Derek gives me the best there.
Good job.
McVin, absolutely great.
Yeah, it's Gabby Nixon's twin sister in that.
What?
Delray in front of the net as they score! Gabby Nixon with their second on the dice!
Speaking of Nixon, didn't you just say her name?
Speaking of Nixon!
Holy moly! And Nixon just absolutely kept in a heat wave, having 7 goals in 6 games. Just absolutely on fire. Fire up, shit. Nixon able to just take her time and find the puck, just like Del Rey does, just taking her time, being cool, calm, and collected in those situations. And she has a great shot as she notches number.
Many chances that play wasn't able to. Saudi. Saudi across ice to Del Rey. Del Rey, double team. As it's stolen. Nixon, can she make it 3? No, she did not. Just why? Nixon, into the corner. Up top, over here. And Dallas and Travis gets pushed off the pump, though. one-on-one here, as that's going to be deflected off over to the corner. Took her a second to find where that book was able to go grab it in the corner, though. Cross ice pass stolen. Saudi trying to get into a teammate. Finally, she's able to find one. There's Nixon. Nixon going wide.
This is Hubert.
Hubert, sorry. Bell red. There it is, the Whitest. Whitest blocks in front, but might have hit Hubert. Sorry, hard to see the jerseys from that angle.
It is. We're calling this out too. We get Nixon and Hubert next time. They both have
60s
on their back.
There it is. Wilson over to that Hubert. Stolen. That was stolen by Goebbels. Shot just wide. That might have been deflected off the Abraham.
Yeah. Lost control. 5 seconds left in the second period. Kick it out. Kick it through. We'll be back here at CCHN. Derek and I will give you the intermission report. We'll be back in the third period.
Good, you got your initial report. What did I say about the sweatshirt? What? No, you're good. I'm just giving you crap.
The work rates we have with the fur.
So the only one you have to do is the 10-minute mark one. Yep. And then plug the Optimex post game show, which I'll do that. Okay.
There we go. Now everyone can hear us. It's hard during play-by-play and graphics. Parker, if you're watching this, we need you for graphics starting in the second half, or you will actually be fired.
Dang. That's pretty hard.
As it's going to be an Irish player to get it out of the pile, as Abraham will come out and make that save for the stoppage of play 19-19 left in period number 3.
Hit him with the left, hit him with the right, locks down with north. Locking these pucks down like
that was actually kind of clean.
I think I messed up on that. I did it earlier in the season, if you guys remember.
My phone is being blown up right now. Like, not literally, but figuratively. As Del Rey will go coast to coast to grab that. I thought, what? There's shadows from that glass. So it looked like the judge waved it off, but I see will be the fall. As that will come back into the Chippewas zone. Either there's shadows along the boards or I'm just losing it. Maybe a little bit above.
Going back to your point, are the girls sitting in on your phone or is it coming on?
I think that's not that one either. As that will come right in front of us. Now play is starting to complete the third and the two there single team. Is that splash in front? Jumping in front of the bat. Is that scoring into the corner? You're never used to having, what is this, like 2 inches thick of glass between you and the players. Like, why is it the Irish players was like right next to me? Encroaching on my personal space. Is that what's going to be safe? Not me, man. 1833 left in period number 3.
Yeah, whenever these players are coming towards the boards, I feel like it's just going to be a huge smack, like you see in the NHL and the boys, but you don't see a lot of that in the boys division.
You do not, unfortunately. Do not understand that rule, but it is what it is.
And they don't want to break their feelings or anything else.
As Hubert wins the draw, shot off the draw, just why? As that was Amy going along the edge to grab it, Wilson as it came to end. Irish off the back shot. Just got an Abraham. She's ready to make that save. She's already backing off up.
Yeah, her eyes are just right on it.
As Huber has an accolade in front of the crease, Huber gets a back row.
Uh-oh.
As there's to be a call, someone's going to the sin bin. See what the penalty. I believe there's going to be a penalty there.
Hubert taking a ball.
Maybe not.
Russell talking it up.
No, there is. See what the number is. That is 4. Claire Flood.
What? That's a pretty cool game. 17:52 left here in the third period. Puck is rattling around the left, right boards here. All the way down near Abraham and the assistant captain, Emily Castellini.
See what the Chippewas can do on the power play, their first shot of the night. First penalty by Adam comes at the 208 mark of period number 3. As we said in the second period, it's been a very clean game by both teams. As there's Nixon trying to get into the puck, was able to possess the dump into the Chippewas zone. Maybe the air will go and slow that down for Wes. Wes up and back to Nixon. Nixon tried to get into the air, was able to. Why does Gold come back there? As the Antino pulls off the ice, that's Hubert and Tom's on. As Castillo just wide of her stick. As that one, once again, is cleared by the Irish. 50 seconds left on the flood triple penalty. Williams at center ice.
Williams. Delray, back to Williams. Williams up top to Palmer. Palmer will take the shot on that. Saved by McVay. 26 seconds left on the penalty. 16-18 left in the period. Correction on the penalty. That was McKenna going to the box, not Flood.
So we all know that Kylie Del Rey has a lot of goals, 17. But we have other players like Williams, Nixon, and Zoe Saudi approaching that double digit mark. Nixon only needs one more goal to get number 10.
Do you think she'll get it here tonight, Matt?
Well, I don't want to jinx it, like I said.
Good job. He's learning.
I'm
so proud of him.
But she's doing an awesome job. She can knock one more and be the top snatcher of the season.
As there's going to be a whistle, stoppage and play, offside. No, that is not offside. That's going to stay in the Chippewa zone. Might be another hand pass. Nonetheless, they saw a ball come to the left of Abraham. 2 seconds left in the McKenna tripping penalty. Delray will take the face off for the chips. Loses it. But that's going to be wrapped along the court. Weiss was there to stop it. Oh, as Weiss football tackles her lady, penalty upcoming. As that's touched up by the chips.
Yeah.
It's going to be a high stick on Weiss.
Yeah, I don't know about that call, but she was definitely being very aggressive and kind of taking down a Irish player and talking to Whitus earlier this week. She says, you know, the people in Canada, they go rough. They play really rough compared to, you know, the teams that she's been playing against this year. And
Canadians know how to do hockey.
Yeah, I mean,
there.
They're known to be nice Canadians, but, you know, they take hockey seriously.
They're mean once they get off the ice, or once they get out of the ice. But that's going to be saying hi, Abraham.
So Whitus using her Canadian blood to implementing that into this game.
I like that high stick penalty there. She clearly hit her player above the... what would be the belt above the waist. First penalty kill of the night for the tip off of Irish shot on the play. 1.2 left in the Welsh penalty. And that's going to be saved by Abraham. Nice save there by the Lord. Able to locate the puck. As that was an Irish player who hit the deck. It was McKenna who hit the deck after the shot.
McKenna just like falling over on her back and she laughs it off.
Both teams are able to get a line checked off. See who it is to take the face off. It's going to be Delray to take the face off against McKenna. One by McKenna. As that's going to be taken out of the zone. There's the offside call.
Great job, Williams.
Good call there by the line stretch.
Williams doing a fantastic job forcing the Irish to make a mistake and walk into an offside penalty. Still need Mac Barnett, Captain Bapp, as well as Williams and Delray.
Delray will try and clear this. Mac will be able to clear the puck as it goes the length of the ice. No icy call, though. Delray tried to get that one. She had a short-handed goal in the Chicago series.
Yeah, it seems like the whole team had a goal in that series. Scoring 17 in both total.
Scored 9 goals Saturday, 8 goals Sunday.
Yeah. It was averaging
1 minute and 3 seconds left on the ledge penalty. 14-40 in period number 3. Derek Skill alongside Matt Ryder, Todd Palmer, our cameraman tonight. Glad to have you from Compton Family Ice Arena, first of a 2-game series between the Fighting Irish and the Chippewas. Central Michigan comes in on a 3-game winning streak, two-game winning streak, trying to extend it to three games. Irish finally had a 5-game winning streak against the Chippewas. Last CMU win was February 18th, 2018.
This will be Hughes having a first win against his squad in 5 years after getting shut out in 2 games last season.
Yeah, it's not for a snowball and then slide is not sure. It just gets stuck in the first round. As a multitude of players took the ball, Nixon tried to steal it, but it's going to go out to Sonny. 8 seconds left, 7, 6. As the Chippewas are going to be able to kill off the penalty, they are back by the short corner on top of the bench to clear that one into the zone. 13:30 left in the period. I'm surprised the Irish didn't pull their goalie though. When they had the forecheck, the penalty was upcoming. Normally, the team would pull their goalie to get a 6-game on the ice.
Yeah, usually it happens at the end of the game, so I think the Irish are trusting their players to stick in this one until we narrow down to the last couple minutes.
Red Wings looking at a 4-1 deficit against the Vegas Golden Knights tonight. Man, what a week it's been for the Red Wings. And from winners of 4 in a row now, this will be their third straight loss. Losing to Toronto and Buffalo this week. And then obviously Vegas tonight.
Yeah, they started off the season hot. Going for a rough patch right now, so hopefully
they can. Quarantine for the young team.
Yeah, hopefully they can figure things out, and that's why it's a long season. But very excited to see the squad racking up a good amount of wins so far.
Be joined for the Wildcats show today, beating Wisconsin Eau Claire.
Eau Claire.
5-1. From the arena. We were out there earlier this year. That's two really nice arenas a lot of fans have there. My personal favorite arena has to be Barrie so far this year.
I like this one a lot. I walked into this arena and my eyes just popped wide open.
It's just a history from the campus. We're going to be able to walk around the campus a little bit on 12:30. I'm excited. It's a history with this campus you hear about, and finally being able to be here, it's been a surreal
day. Have you heard of the Touchdown Jesus?
What?
Touchdown Jesus?
No, I haven't.
There's a big kind of picture on a building. It's Jesus, and they call it Touchdown Jesus. I think he's putting his hands up in the air. A touchdown.
Notre Dame loving their football here, though. They had the hotel we're staying in had Notre Dame football flags, and here in the hotel, I'm searching the bottom. We were able to see that Notre Dame flag they had in the entryway at the bottom.
Yeah, yeah. Bob Evans, yum.
Yes, that Bob Evans was, their slogan was yum today.
Yeah, I got called out for that.
Oh, I really thought Delray was going to take a shot there. It's that she elects to pass over to Nixon. Has it deflected right to an Irish player? No worries, though, as it went to the top and pass it to Kiskele. 10:58 left in the period.
Chippewas flying around in this third period. Keeping that intensity even by being up 5-0. That's Haney's go-to.
Delray with the puck, passes it, stolen. And sure, that was deflected by an Irish player. Could not tell who that was, as it's going to be stealing to chase it down into the corner. No ice involved. White and Schreps are on the court. Out to the blue line for the puck, kicking outside. Right to White is out. A nice football pick there by Leontino. Sorry, basketball. Did you see that little pick Leontino had there on the Irish defender?
Yeah, and I think she's had another opportunity for a pick as well. I mean, you know, she's been all over the ice tonight. Her and Palmer, you can see the intensity throughout this game. And
They're staying on top of it. And it's leading to the other teammates as well. They're playing a great game.
9:31 left in period. Chippewas.
To the Notre Dame Fighting Irish, trying to also extend their winning streak on the season of 3 games. Their only loss of the season came to the 18 goal lock from Arrington. Adrian, you made the top ranking in the Central ECHA rankings, all by these very Chippewas, right on the heels and the CMU Cougars. Hope to get a scoring update from that game. That's happening in Michigan State.
Uh-oh, there. Trouble.
Barnett and Elmer coming to the public is Elmer coming off of it. Barney and Beards.
The captains. There's
Wilson trying to do something. She will go outside with it. That is stolen though. As Castillo will skip the ice, as that's going to be called icing.
Fans, be sure to tune in to CCHN tomorrow for the conclusion of this weekend series against the Fighting Irish. The broadcast is scheduled to start at 12:30 p.m. and will be right here on CCHN, your home for Chippewa hockey. I'll be play-by-play for that, and Derek will be the color.
With 7 minutes left in the first half, they are able to win. If the Tucson lost, the USC lost, they're guaranteed a playoff spot with a win. And that is saved, I believe.
It's hard to see. Yeah, you got
nice
2020
vision. By Nick then. That's two really good saves she's made on that side of the ice tonight. She's had a really solid game for the Irish.
Oh, yeah. After the first period, only giving up 2 goals so far.
Whitus, shot, ricocheting off of the kit. As that's going to be cleared by the Irish. We're on the porch up, jumping into the zone. As Castillo's going to come back to grab it. Off the boards to Barnett, up ahead, has it stolen to Nixon. As that's going to be right back there into the porch along the end boards. Over to Wilson. Wilson has a stolen by an Irish player. Found it. Saved by Abraham. Did you like that flip of the puck here by Abraham?
Flip of the puck.
She's having
the rest
fun tonight.
Oh, yeah, she is. She's making a lot of noble saves. And to your point, to our goalie, or to the goalie for the Irish, she's been making a lot of noble stops, only giving up 2 goals after the first period. And for not playing a lot, you know, this season, they've only played 4 games as a team before this game. And, you know, for this team to be competing with one of the best teams in the conference, in the Chippewas, it's a great sign to see.
Hubert with it, we're up on the net. Tries to get it out to a teammate, was able to get it to Palmer. Palmer over to Haney. Haney in front of the net. There's traffic there. As that's going to be cleared by McKenna. Watch out, McKenna, one on one. McKenna, three shot at the net. Oh, wow. Tries to get the defense there back corner, though, not giving up on that play.
Yeah, they're getting their opportunities for sure. The breakaways, but they're just not able to hit the puck and to secure those shot opportunities. But they're getting those breakaway opportunities for sure.
6.5 minutes left in this one from Compton. As there's Hubert, that is Hubert. Doubt. Pestered by the Chippewas defense, Hubert's going to come out with it. So they show their options. Still surveying. Now she's going, trying to get it up ahead to Saudi.
as there's going to be icing called on the Chippewas.
So, like I said, the Irish squad have played 4 games so far before this game. And a little recap, they started out against Miami, lost 8-4, and then they beat Miami 5-4, and then Adrian came to their place and they took care of business, Adrian Bulldogs, 6-1 and 8-4. So, 4 games, this is number 5, not getting a lot of reps for the team, but able to just stick with in this game with the Chippewas, you know, 5-0. So, I think it attests that they got some players. I believe 9 of their players are veterans, or juniors or seniors, talking with the head coach early in the game.
We'll try and get up ahead, but Delray isn't able to. I think Delray just had a bad game on that one. Nixon will call gets it up. Zaudi, watch out, Delray. Delray, that's numbers. Kylie Delray. Shot at that good on the upcoming Eshie. Scores. No sent by McVin.
Oh my goodness. McVin. Delray had a beautiful opportunity there, just cutting down on the right side of the boards and using that backhand. But McVin able to see that down and make the stop, but I think she's trying to get up.
Once again, McVin will get her laces tied by a teammate. Faceoff is going to go to her left.
You keep thinking she's hurt. She's only getting her shoes tied.
I thought there might have been a penalty there. Doesn't look. Oh, there is. We're on the Irish. That's 26. For Zedwick. And that's a 2-minute for high sticking.
Under 5 minutes to go, and the Chippewas flying around, controlling the puck. As Caitlin Williams takes it down the middle, she has a one-on-one opportunity, taking her time being smooth with the puck. But that is a turnover.
That's going to be clear. And then the Delray. Delray trying to find a teammate, goes across ice to Miriam. Just another strong for her, as that's going to not be called an icing.
That was a great shot from our end, seeing Delray going across the ice pass to Caitlin Williams. Caitlin Williams unable to hold it down as it was jumping.
Chippewas, hard play, hasn't looked that strong tonight. It's been kind of off. 40 seconds left in the high school penalty, though. Delray, up ahead to Nixon. Nixon, back to Delray. Delray shot on that, and she scores! Kylie Delray proving me wrong. Power play goal, number 18 on the season, 6-0 in favor of the Chippewas.
Did you choose her for like the net?
I did.
Wow. Dude, oh my goodness, Delray having that opportunity. She's just always in the zone. I mean, to my point, she was on the left boards here, right next to us, and makes a cross the ice pass to Caitlin Williams. And then she just goes down the other end and notches her second goal of the night with 3.5 minutes to go. And just seeing this game so far, they're just working on their passes, having no-look passes out here. We're looking like the Kansas City Chiefs, you know, just implementing these crazy plays that you don't see a lot of teams do.
Must be the Kansas City Chiefs when they're not playing the Bills, eh, Matt? Unless you're talking about the playoffs, and then that's
completely different story, but we.
Jolt of energy. I might have to use that once.
Sure, I'll let
you borrow. I'll quote you when I use that though, Matt.
Just for turning back. Yeah.
I'll put that in my 2x5.
Oh! Oh! Whitest.
Whitest. Shot on that. Saved by McNay.
Oh,
if there's a Chippewa player in it, but that guy was whitest.
No call, Rascal.
Distillery off the boards, up ahead, tried to get it to T-Bird, was able to, as that's going to be circling on the net. As Amy's going up that roll, no icy call, as he did not make that call. I think she let that go all the way, so icy went home.
Two minute warning,
1:46 left in the game. 1:40 left. Chippewas enjoying a 6-0 lead. Make sure to stay tuned for the afternoon game. We will have 3 stars of the game with our little players. Post on one. That's a post game show. Brought to you by Optimus Sports. As there's Schubert. As Schubert goes down. Amy will rename the puck ball.
It's a slip and slide party.
Leotino. Becky Castillo, your 10 now. We'll try to get it up to Wilson, is able to. Wilson over to Nixon. Nixon tried to get a shot off, was able to. Good defense here by the Irish. 59 seconds left. Irish on the forecheck. There's Steve Smith shot, deflected by the Ingram. 47 seconds left. Williams will chase it. Brought down by Poole. As Palmer hits play. There's Steve Smith inside the rebound. Saved by Abraham. And that's going to get a bunch of bars from the Chippewas faithful. As that one's going to go right in the lane. But still, Ray can chase it down. She can. There's a shot on that. Saved by McFed. And that one's going to be ricocheted off. 18 seconds left. Delray, 15 seconds left. Williams, 13 seconds left. As this one's going to come out, a CMU victory. Final score of 6-0. 000 hit. 6-0 is the final score from Compton Family Ice Arena. Chippewas approved to 10-1 on the season. Great showing by Lauren Abraham. We'll break that down plus a lot more on the OptimX postgame show right after this. Once again, they made history tonight, breaking that 5-2, also getting Abraham their second career shutout as a CMU Chippewa. The only score we talked about in the third period was that they were powerful goal at 16:25 mark. The Chippewas were 1-2 on the power play. I do you want to talk about the last game? No, that was good. Cesarevichek. That's how you say it. It's Russian. There is a Russian player on the Irish team apparently this year. But she had a high stick at the 15-minute mark. That led to the power play goal. Bring the Chippewas up 6-0, which they won with that final score. Looking at our players to watch for tonight, we have Delray and Williams. Delray had 2 goals and assists. Williams had 2 assists.
Yeah, I mean, Delray almost had her career capture of the season, I think. You know, she definitely, she was in the zone. I could tell we were really close to the players. She made some great plays. Same game, actually, it's 2 goals. So, with a goalie for the Irish, so it's a big thing. Made a lot of moments. That first period was giving up three goals. In the second and third period, so she did an amazing job of that.
Speaking of the other, she was one of the 2 players to watch for the Irish. The other one was the machine without victory. She had the 5-0 She really didn't make the final turn on the machines. Then one of the top scorers for the Irish team this year.
Go back to our team.
Research in the game, he started with the third game, third star. He gave it to Daniel, makes it 2 goals, Research in the World Cup, and died out. Second star of the game, man, I thought we'd never say that the famous player has second star. She's always been seeming to get first star of like, it's Delray, Kylie Delray, 2 goals and assists, bringing her total up to 18 on the season. It's points total to 29 on the season. Yes, you heard that right, 25 points through 11 games for Delray.
Insane, only 11 games. He's definitely the superhero.
First start of the game goes to who I like to refer to as Spider-Man. It's the one in here. Look, when you pitch a shutout, you get. Oh, my God. You get your shutout. Great game from her in that all night tonight.
Yeah. Oh.
You probably say that I'm not sitting here with the tweet and second and third. Do not sit in the last third. Do not sit in the last third.
I'll get you a call.